What's up guys, Father Wolf here, and today I'm joined with That Dog Cody, and today we're doing an interview video. You can say hi. So why did you tell you about yourself?
About myself? Well, I'm That Dog, as you know, obviously. I live in the PNW, Pacific Northwest, and I do entertainment and content creation mostly for a living. I'm a dog. That dog. There you go.
So, excuse me. Have you ever been to a convention before?
Oh yeah, I've been to a good few conventions. I had the pleasure of going to a few. FWA, I was at this year, and I was gonna say last year, but we're still in this year, and it was an amazing con, a lot of fun, a lot of good energy, a lot of good music. I'm going to be at FC this coming year, and I'm also planning to be at BFF coming in March as well.
Okay. Just give me 1 second. What about, are you going to Ferdu as well?
Well, I mean, funny enough as you say that, I mean, I've been to Australia several times. I love traveling. Traveling is something I'm very passionate about. And I was thinking about this coming year, but the stars didn't align. But I'm going to say 2024, it's highly likely I will put my reservation in the effort. I've always wanted to go.
Well, the only convention I wanted to go is to Awara, if you heard of that convention.
Where's that at?
Sydney.
I have heard of smaller ones here and there, but for me, being that where I live right now, I think Ferdu is the one that pops up the most in conversation, at least. So, I don't know of all the other ones that go around, but, I mean, any of the comps would be great, to be honest.
Cool. And also, what inspired you to become as a furry?
What inspired me? Well, you know, I think with furry, like anything else, I think it's something that you just have an affinity towards. You might not really know what that is. Like for me, I always had certain affinities towards anthropomorphic characters, and then I was in mascot characters, and I always felt like I had a stronger connection to them. So when I found furry, I felt like everything that I kind of liked but didn't know how to categorize it all kind of fit into that mold, and then the fandom of it kind of just fit exactly like what I said, what the interest that I had, what really kind of like excited me, what I had an interest in, what I loved watching, and once I figured that out, it was mostly just from there, just going to meets and hangouts and eventually to a con and falling in love with the fandom more and more as I met really cool people.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing lately too, you know, meeting a lot of good people in the fandom too, which is a really fun thing to do, too.
There's a lot of very awesome people in the fandom, a lot of very talented individuals, and a lot of people that have a lot of different interests. I think the fandom is probably, as much as we're all connected by one single means, which is the love for anthropomorphic characters of some variety, we are very creative and very talented in very many facets, if it's from technology to the creative arts, so travel to automobiles, mechanics, so I think there's something for everybody, essentially.
Cool. Excuse me. Alright, what else? What's a good question I should give you? How long have you been doing YouTube videos?
Well, the videos that I've been doing with Coda specifically, I've been doing for about, I would say more actively in the last 6 to 8 months, a little bit over a year in total. I've worked a couple jobs on the side as well. So trying to divide my time evenly, obviously has been kind of like a balancing act, but I'm getting better at it. So come 2023, expect a lot more videos on YouTube and, you know, TikTok and all the other stuff I do. But I used to do YouTube before that with other skits and also music, just not with this character and in a different style of content, we'll say.
You know, I want to ask this question too, but you can probably, you know, tell them too. But if anyone's out there too that wants to start a YouTube channel and stuff like that and so started, just let you guys know that it's very difficult to make YouTube videos, trust me. I do it all the time and it's hard a bit. It gets hard to make thumbnails and edit a lot. Even making like live streams and stuff, it's super hard to do. Because you're only doing it by yourself, but if you're doing it with other friends, it's okay.
Videos that has a labor of love aspect to it. Great. It's rewarding, but it does take some effort. Obviously.
Well, before Fiber Wolf, I had 3 other channels too, but it wasn't like furry related. It's just to test my limits to see what goes on. Yeah, I've been a YouTuber for.
Son wasn't furry either.
I started being a furry since, I don't know, probably 5 years ago. And then I had a YouTube channel called Fireball 2069, but it wasn't based on furries at all. But basically, I've been a YouTuber for like 5 years now, basically. And but this was way before I started Fireball Wolf. But let me tell you, this channel has gone good.
That's good. Yeah. It's about finding something that you vibe with, right? It's about finding that you identify with and vibe with, because you want to put the effort into it, obviously, and you want to be interested in the content. Because YouTube has to be longer videos, right? Like, as you know. So for people who want to get interested in making YouTube videos, you know, you got to fill a certain time gap. So, if you're so passionate about it, you're going to have, like for me personally, when I make YouTube videos, I actually have a harder time cutting it down than making it short. Like, my videos can, on average, be well over 15, 20 minutes, and I have to like try to cut it down because I have so much stuff I want to talk about in a video, and I'm like, no, I can't. I have to make it shorter because, I mean, it's all great, but you want to kind of like make it. You want to make it flow, so yeah, because I'm passionate about what I do.
And I was talking about something just a second ago. My voice just cracked about one time. There we go. It's a blooper. Wow. Alright.
Voice crack.
Yeah. But it doesn't matter, we can still go. So, how many years have you been in the fandom?
Interesting because I had interest in the fandom, but I never really like dived into it. You know when you kind of like you look at it from like an outside lens, and you're like, oh, that's interesting, because you have like an inclination towards it, but you don't dive into it right away, and then you come back to it, and you're like, no, that's pretty cool. I really want to go to a con, or really want to get a suit, or this and that. That's kind of how I dealt with it. I saw it previously. Videos and people doing stuff, they kind of like, oh, you know, that's cool, and then I kind of circle back, and then I'm like, no, like, that's, like, really cool, and then I got into it. So long enough, as time bearing, enough to see a lot of things change, a lot of new cons pop up over time.
I was just counting how much questions I was asking, but I think that was a lot of questions. I think it was. Wasn't it? Yeah, pretty sure it was, wasn't it?
You asked quite a few.
Yeah, I did ask quite a few. I should ask one more, hey.
10-minute interview, you can ask one more. I think with all these questions, you'll probably get about 15 minutes worth of content.
Yeah. I think that's about it. Alright, that's it for the interview video. If you guys want to go subscribe to That Dog Cody, and if you want to go follow him on Twitter, I'll put a link in the description. And if you want me and him to do videos in the coming future, please let me know, and I will make videos with him. Do you want to say anything before I go?
Bark, yeah. Yeah, like, follow, subscribe to my channel as well as Fireballs. And if you like the content, always up for good ideas and suggestions. And you can also as well anytime if you have anything you want to discuss, talk about, or fun thing you could film together.
Alright, that's it for this video. If you guys want, please like, subscribe, turn the notification on, follow me on Twitter, follow me on TikTok, also TikTok too. You can add me, if you guys haven't already, join my Discord server. Please join my Discord server, it's in the link at the top of the YouTube page. You can go there and it takes you straight to my server. So, that's all for this video. Fireballwolf is out. Tell me that you love me, even if it's fake.